If you think about all of the landscapes of planet Earth, the coastal old-growth forests of Vancouver Island rank up there as among the most beautiful anywhere on this planet. These spectacular lowlands are sort of like the redwoods of Canada. You've got these primeval thousand-year-old ancient trees covered in moss, and you've got all this spectacular wildlife, the large herbivores and the large carnivores that follow them. This is the way Earth used to be everywhere, and we still have pockets of it here, but they're endangered.
So in my hand here is a trail camera that runs on a motion-activated sensor. And when we've left it in the woods for about a year and a half now, and anytime an animal walks by, like a deer or a bear, it records a video. And today we just checked it, and we have some really incredible footage of a black bear climbing right up the face of an old-growth red cedar tree here in the Eden Grove and climbing into a giant cavity on the face of the tree. It's kind of like Christmas. When you open a present, you're not quite sure what you're gonna get, but today we really got what we wanted.
We're in the Lower Edinburgh Grove, also nicknamed the Eden Grove. This is one of the last of the lowland ancient forests left on southern Vancouver Island. It's as rare as a black rhino. This is really one of the most spectacular ancient forests around. It's got the classic hallmarks of a lowland ancient forest. Lots of giant trees, fallen woody debris, an open canopy which lets sunlight through, so that's why you have such a luxuriant understory, and a lot of wildlife.
It's pretty hard to actually get a glimpse of the wildlife that exists in these forests, but with a camera like this you can really see those candid moments that go on all the time. Black bears are not necessarily endangered, but they do thrive in forests like this, especially where they're red cedars that have those hollow cavities. They can use those as dens in wintertime.
These ancient forests are jam-packed with charismatic wildlife, with black bears, with cougars, with wolves, with Roosevelt elk, with deer. And there's endangered old-growth species in the area. This is a northern goshawk nesting area, a species at risk, as well as marbled murrelets, long-eared bats, vos swifts. It's a place that is essentially like an ancient forest Serengeti for southern Vancouver Island, and we've got to get it saved.
Coming through the Walbrand Valley, you saw not one but two cougars running across the road, and actually got a video clip and a photograph of the cougars actually just through the front window of the car. But my hopes is that if we take this camera back and install it in that same location, maybe we'll get some extra footage of them wandering around. I mean, they're such elusive creatures, you can go your whole life without actually seeing one. Slime molds, they're the new poster child of old growth forests.
Port Renfrew has become dubbed as the tall tree capital of Canada. It's sort of reinvented itself as an ecotourism hub in recent years because of the old growth forests. You don't need to log the last ancient forest to have rural economies thrive.
You see enormous trees like this western red cedar right here. These trees can grow upwards of 13, 14, even 15 feet in diameter in this region. This one's probably in the 10 to 12 foot range, and they can live for 500 to 1,000 years old.
So there's snowballing support for saving ancient forests. It's not just environmentalists and protesters anymore, but the BC Chamber of Commerce recently passed a resolution calling on the BC government to expand protections of old growth forests.
Once these forests are gone, they're gone. And to take that opportunity away from future generations to experience something as grand as this, it just isn't right.
The 1994 land use plan is old, outdated, wasn't based on modern conservation science, wasn't based on First Nations traditional knowledge, didn't have hardly any First Nations input at all, and it needs to be updated. So the AVIC is the Association of Vancouver Island and Coastal Communities, recommended that the government amend the land use plan to protect the remaining old growth forests on Vancouver Island.